Regarded as one of the most influential composers of jazz, Miles Davis contributed much to the genre over his lifelong musical career. Davis discovered his love for music at a very early age and continued to cultivate this passion throughout his life. He contributed to the development of several subgenres of jazz, such as bebop, cool jazz, and fusion jazz. Here we will explain a little about his life, his major accomplishments, and his contribution to fusion jazz. Miles Dewey Davis III was born May 26, 1926, into a middle-class family in Alton, Illinois. His father, Miles Davis Jr., was a dentist who had grown up on land owned by the Davis family in Arkansas. During the time of slavery, the Davis family had been a family of musicians, but after slavery was abolished, they turned away from music to pursue more prestigious careers. By the time Miles Davis III was born, the family had established himself well enough to allow him to address his interest in music. About a year after Davis was born, his family moved to East St. Louis. Throughout his childhood, Davis enjoyed listening to Duke Ellington, Count Basie, Louis Armstrong, and others on a radio program called Harlem Rhythms. His family's musical history and this radio show may have been what sparked Davis's passion for music at such an early age. On his 13th birthday, Davis's father gave him a trumpet and hired Elwood Buchanan for one-on-one trumpet lessons. Davis began to receive daily instruction from Buchanan and also joined his school's band. Over the years, he developed his trumpeter skills and became well-known as a young musician. When he was about 17, Davis was asked to sit in for a sick band member by Dizzy Gillespie and Charlie Parker, marking his first onstage appearance with professional jazz musicians. In 1944, Davis moved to New York and enrolled in the Institute of Musical Art, now known as Juilliard. While studying at Juilliard, Davis linked back up with Charlie Parker and began to play jazz in nightclubs around Harlem. A year later, Davis left Juilliard to become a full-time musician. He started out as a member of the Charlie Parker Quintet and later formed the Miles Davis Sextet, in which he recorded his first music as band leader. Over the next few years, Davis developed his improvisational skills and continued to record music with Charlie Parker. In 1949, Davis recorded several songs with his newly formed nine-piece band. These songs were later compiled into an album called The Birth of Cool, which was regarded by many as important influences on modern jazz. Davis added a few instruments in his nine-piece band that normally had not been included in conventional jazz ensembles. The French horn, trombone, and tuba helped to contribute to tone colors and dynamics that Davis experimented with to achieve new sound. Unfortunately, in the 1950s, Davis battled with drug addiction, which briefly set his musical career on the back burner. However, after overcoming his addiction, he landed a contract with Columbia Records and formed a new six-man band. Davis's new band consisted of musical greats John Coltrane, Paul Chambers, and Red Garland. Together, they were able to record one of the greatest jazz albums, Kind of Blue, which sold more copies than any other jazz album in history. The success of this album boosted his popularity and opened the door for Davis to continue to reinvent the jazz genre. Throughout the 1960s, Davis and his band went through various changes. Band members came and went, and they constantly experimented with new styles. Jazz was not the only genre that changed during this time period. New musical concepts were being explored by artists such as Jimi Hendrix, The Doors, and Sly and the Family Stone. These musicians and many others may have influenced Davis as he helped to create a new type of jazz that fused musical elements found in rock and R&B with the improvisational styles of traditional jazz. Fusion jazz, or jazz rock, began in the 1960s and remained popular throughout the 1990s. Jazz bands incorporated electrical instruments, which would normally be found in rock groups, and combined jazz improvisation with rock musical forms. Fusion jazz bassists assumed a more melodic role in addition to a more traditional functions of providing the beat and emphasizing the harmonic foundation. These groups also included more percussion instruments than traditional jazz bands, which allowed for new tone colors and rhythmic patterns to be utilized. Miles Davis released his first album featuring fusion jazz in 1969. Recorded in about 3 days, Bitches Brew featured electric instruments and sounds borrowed from the rock genre. Although the album was not received well by traditional jazz fans, it soon reached the top of the charts. The album included 7 tracks, each consisting of electrified instruments. The track John McLaughlin, named after the band's guitar player, features McLaughlin playing improvised solos on electric guitar. The opening track, Pharaoh's Dance, is accompanied by Larry Young, who plays the electric piano. In both of the songs, listeners can hear traces of psychedelic-sounding riffs and long solos which became popular in the 1960s and 70s. Miles Davis continued to play music and record new albums until he died in 1991. Regarded as one of the most influential contributors to jazz, he accumulated over 9 Grammy Awards and received a Lifetime Achievement Award. Here we have explained a little about the life of Miles Davis, his major accomplishments, and his contribution to fusion jazz. Although he's no longer alive, his music will continue to intrigue listeners and influence artists for years to come.